Welcome to the ESD Essentials video series, which will cover the fundamentals of electrostatic discharge protection. In today's video, we will cover the working voltage of ESD, also known as reverse standoff voltage, and how it is different from the more commonly known breakdown voltage. This video is the second entry in a six-part video series. You can find these videos and more at ti.com/ESD. First, let's take a look at how an ESD diode responds during normal operation. The graph on the right-hand side shows the current voltage response of the diode. When the interface signal is passing through the system, the ESD diode is effectively invisible and no current passes through it. However, when an ESD strike occurs, the voltage across the diode exceeds a certain threshold known as the breakdown voltage, and the diode begins to conduct and shunt current to ground. Let's take a closer look at this current voltage curve on a logarithmic plot. As the input voltage approaches the diode's breakdown voltage, defined by the 1 milliamp current level in the plot, the diode will begin to conduct a significant level of current. This current will continue to increase with voltage. Ideally, the diode current should be zero for any voltage less than the breakdown voltage. However, in the real world, there will always be some leakage current, as you can see from the plot. At TI, we spec a VRWM, or working voltage, at max 10 nanoamps. This working voltage value can be interpreted as the maximum voltage recommended without excessive leakage. As a result, the interface signal voltage should not exceed VRWM. For example, if your operating signal has a voltage range of 0 volts to 3.6 volts, you should select an ESD diode that has a working voltage of 3.6 volts or slightly higher. Anything less, and the diode will leak current during normal operation. By having this margin between working voltage and breakdown voltage, we account for variations across temperature and process. ESD diodes typically come in two polarity configurations, bidirectional and unidirectional. Bidirectional diodes usually have a symmetric IV curve with symmetric working and breakdown voltages. Because of this, bidirectional diodes can support signals with a negative and positive range, granted it falls between negative VRWM and positive VRWM. On the other hand, unidirectional diodes are not symmetric and break down for almost any negative voltage. As a result, unidirectional diodes only support positive voltage signals between 0 and VRWM. However, unidirectional diodes usually offer better negative ESD protection and clamping voltages. In summary, both bidirectional and unidirectional diodes protect against positive and negative ESD strikes. However, bidirectional ESD diodes have a positive and negative breakdown voltage, so they can support all signals within their working voltage range. Unidirectional diodes can only support interfaces that have a positive voltage range, such as USB, HDMI, and other digital inputs. But the benefit is that they offer better negative ESD protection. Different diodes have different working voltages, so be sure to evaluate this parameter when selecting an ESD protection solution. Thank you for watching. To keep learning about ESD, watch our next video on the IEC 61000-4-2 rating. For more details on ESD in general, go to ti.com/ESD.